Hey, what's going on, everybody? Ali Mehdaoui here with another one for you, and it is the amazing, incredible Monday, and you are here with me while you could have been anywhere in the world. I appreciate that. So I got a good one for you today, and one that may be personal to many, many of you. What I mean is, do you find yourself struggling with fear? Do you find yourself in a situation where fear is just holding you back, keeping you from greatness? Well, I was there too. I can assure you that just like you, I have my own inner fears. I still do. I'm still scared many, many times to death of talking to certain people or doing certain things or kind of getting outside my comfort zone. But I want to break it down to you so you understand the philosophy behind fear and how you can actually use it to your own advantage, how you can create within that fear itself greatness. Hello, hello, everybody. I see you from all over the world. Do us a favor. If you are here for the very first time, make sure that in the comment box, you write down your name so we can give you a shout out and where you are jumping in from. And at the same time, make sure you share this video because there are many people out there who are afraid of public speaking, who are afraid of their own greatness, of their own potential, and you can bless them with an opportunity to get out of that funk. So let's get right ahead and get into it. So fear is really one emotion that every single one of us has. Yeah, we might look courageous at times making phone calls and videos, but before we press that start button for that broadcast or for that recording, for that audio, we were afraid. We were scared. We were wondering. We were telling ourselves certain stories like, is it going to look good? Is it going to sound as good? Should I change this topic? Should I change this subject versus the other subject? And here's the thing. The most toxic force on the planet is resistance. And I'll come back to how that relates to fear. So think about it. Whenever anyone tells you, hey, you should quit smoking, or you should start working out, or you should start, you know, giving up meat, or you should do this, or you should do that, you naturally say, yeah, I know, but that's resistance right there. You are resisting change. You are resisting a process. You are resisting an approach. So resistance on its own is extremely toxic to you because you know through that horrible feeling, right, of being called out, you know that's the right thing to do. You know you have to do it, but you just don't, because again, that resistance, your natural sensors tells you, I am not supposed to change what I've already been doing all this time, all these years. So you got to make sure that you are aware of that. And here's what I'll tell you. Whenever you feel fear, that is a message, that is a sign, that is a hint. This is what I'm supposed to be doing, or there is something greater within me, or there is something more, a bigger, better calling out of life of whatever I'm supposed to be doing. That's why fear is essentially a sign, not a negative emotion. See, we're all afraid, but some of us use fear to pull back and resist change. Others use that fear to say, okay, I'm afraid that I'm going to disappoint my wife and a child that I have on the way. I will do everything in my power to make this thing happen. I will create greatness. I will not allow what I was just afraid of to actually happen to me. When we don't do whatever our heart tells us, we automatically, again, feel that negativity, feel that sorrow. And that really starts with fear. So whenever fear tells you you shouldn't do it, well, your heart just told you, like, that's what you should be doing, you know? And it happens to us all the time. You could be at a networking event and, you know, somebody tells you, go out front and go speak, or, you know, or write a book, or go ahead and make phone calls, call the most successful people you know. Your heart is telling you, this is what you need to be doing. But again, fear sets in. Resistance starts to kick in. That again is what you need to take advantage of and say, okay, my heart is telling me right now what I need to be doing, and the fact that I'm afraid of it is just an evidence that I need to go forward and move forward with it. And here's the thing, you know, the feeling of there is more out of life will come from within, and it's not gonna just happen. You're not gonna go to sleep tonight and wake up in the morning and say, I got this, I am the greatest ever, I will do this. No, it happens a little by little, but again, you gotta pay attention to your fears, your resistance, and use them to your own advantage. Remember, they are hints and signs for you to make greatness happen. Many of us have their dreams, you know, they're ambitious. Some of us even write them down, which, by the way, kudos to you if you're writing down your dreams, if you're writing down those positive things that you are thinking of, because you will manifest, you will act on them, right? So those dreams at times are going to feel so far away, like they are far from being real, from existence. That again is going to play with your inner fear, is going to play on you resisting change, resisting that process that you got to go forward with. And again, here's what happens. Instead of you saying, okay, you know, last 3 months or 4 months have been horrible, I'm so afraid that I won't make it to my goal from now until the end of the year, you should be saying, oh, thank God, there are still 8 more months to go this year, and I'm afraid that I will fall short, so let me turn things up. See, using that fear again to your own advantage instead of using it to cripple you, to kind of, you know, keep you down. Because think about it. Resistance itself feels like boredom. It feels like unhappiness. It feels like sadness. I mean, think about it. Anyone who resists, are they ever happy when they resist to a change, even if it's good for them? I mean, I can tell you by experience and from people that I have known, smoking is one of the hardest habits to give up. And when you're talking to someone who smokes cigarettes and say, hey, this is not good for you, you should quit, you will automatically see resistance. Although they know for a fact it is the right thing to do, but they will go ahead and resist and say, you don't understand. It's been years. I'm stressed. I'm this. I'm that. It just kind of looks ugly when we resist. So think about your business. Whatever it is that you're going to resist and oppose and not go forward with, naturally is a hint for you is you are literally blocking what's good for you. So before you go on and start justifying and start opposing whatever is being proposed before you, make sure that you are evaluating what I'm sharing with you right now to be able to be confident, to be able to have that strength to stand tall and make an educated business decision. There's nothing wrong with being skeptical. There's nothing wrong with rejecting an opportunity because the timing isn't right. But just make sure, nonetheless, that you are making an educated business decision at whatever it is, adding an offer or service in your company or your product or your service, accepting something from someone else, from the marketplace or whatever they are trying to add onto your process or whatnot. I tell people all the time, hey, listen, not the right timing for me. It doesn't mean that I'm resistant. It only means that it's not the right timing for me. But I really think about it. I never make a decision on the spot. I always say yes and think about it later on. But when I do think about it heavily, I go back and I say, hey, it just doesn't seem like it's the right timing for me to do something like this. The most common form of resistance is procrastination. Mino English just kicked in. Ding, 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 ding. Mino English alert. Procrastination. That is the greatest form of resistance. See, we all do this, right? We wake up in the morning. We have a list of things that we're supposed to be doing. I'm guilty of it as much as everybody else. And then we say, well, let me post a positive post on Facebook. Now, we know what's on our list. We know what we need to be doing. And then we get lost in Facebook for 45 minutes. We're still scrolling up, liking, commenting on everybody else. And we're convincing our brain, oh, I'm being supportive to all my friends. I'm commenting on them. But the reality is, you're just procrastinating. You're just pushing back what you need to be doing. And that, my friend, is called resistance. That is the utmost form of resistance. So again, you have to reevaluate whatever you're doing every single day. Think to yourself, what is my income producing activity? Do it. That is your priority. My income producing activity is to acquire new viewers, is to acquire new clientele, is to acquire new clients for our services, for our company, for our product, whatever it is that you are doing. That should be the bulk of your activity. If you're not working towards what makes you money, you will end up going dead broke. So I cannot stress that enough. Make sure that you are not resistant. The more profound matter, how it will actually make you feel after. You know, when you give up, think about it. Think about that one thing that really, really, really scared you one time. I mean, I don't know what it is. Maybe, you know, you were afraid of snakes and you went to a circus and somebody put a snake around your neck, right? Maybe you were afraid of heights and then you went skydiving. Maybe you were afraid of whatever, you know, making a phone call to that one individual that you really wanted in your business. I'll give you a secret, like right now, just literally right now. And most of you would know who he is. Some of you won't. It's okay. You can Google him. A gentleman by the name of Albie Shore. He is a Grammy Award a nominee. He won, you know, different awards throughout his career back in the day, old school R&B. And I've met him a couple of years back in a network marketing event that I was closing a convention at. And we've built a relationship. And we kept on talking. And then every time he has something new for him and, you know, his family, his son or whatever, he shoot me a text message reminding me to watch the new video or watch the show or listen this or listen that. Here's what happened. I was all this time. Now, I've known him for almost going from 2014, from August 2014, it's almost 3 years now that I've known him. I've never reached out to him for none of my processes, none of my companies, none of my businesses, none of my offers. Today, he sent me a text message with a video trailer of him and his son's new song, which is gonna go bonkers everywhere. And for the very first time, I stopped resisting. For the very first time, I sent him a message stating, hey, just so you know, I see you're doing phenomenal things. Now, mind you, this is a Grammy Award nominee. This is a multi-platinum award winner, singer, sold CDs and performed all over the world. So he has a team. But if you don't ask, you won't get. So finally, I manned up and I said, you know what? I am great. I have what it takes. I own a multinational company. I worked with Inc. 500 companies. I've built some processes that have built millions of dollars for other companies that have allowed me and my wife to have a very successful network and release books and spoke on many stages. I am great. And then I send them a message. Hey, Al, listen, man, you know, I'm not sure if you have a team around you and you're doing phenomenal things, but guess what? I'd love to have an opportunity to see if I can be of service to you and your brand. Do you know how that felt? I called my wife. I'm like, you don't know what I just did. I just sent a message to the great Albie Shore himself. I felt amazing. You know, I felt that burden off my shoulder because for 3 years, I knew I needed to call this gentleman. For 3 years that he texts me and he tags me on every single post. This is a celebrity. And I don't send him a message back saying, hey, we should do business together. So for the very first time, and guess what? If he's taken care of, he's taken care of, but at least I took a chance. I did swing that bat. I did not hold back. I did not resist. I will no longer resist. And this is why change starts with me. So I'm showcasing to you that I too have fears. I too have resistance. But I too, just like you, can make a decision and a change just like that. Folks, you know, I talk all the time about thoughts become things. So every single day that we do these videos, I'm going to add one more little piece. And, you know, I got this, the secret daily teaching. And every single day, there is a different quote and a different teaching. And it's literally 10 seconds worth. And I want to leave you with it so you can expand on your thinking, because whatever you think of will make you feel a certain way. And whatever you feel will make you act a certain way. And however you act, it will 100% give you results. So I want you to have the right train of thought. So here is today's secret note. The secret, this is just an introduction, by the way. The secret contains clear principles on how to live your life in accordance with the natural laws of the universe. And the most important thing for any person to do is to live it. You can only become the master of your life by living it. So start living your life. Stop playing small. Stop resisting to the greatness that you have within you. You are a top earner. You are a top executive. You are a great creator. You have everything that you want right within you. It's your resistance that's telling you, I shouldn't invest in myself. It's your resistance that's telling you, I'm afraid. You're not afraid. You're just resisting. You're just focusing on what shouldn't or what couldn't possibly happen instead of the greatness that you have before you that can happen. Do you know if I thought to myself all this time for the last 9 years, what if it doesn't work? I'll still be flipping burgers in Ruby Tuesday as we speak right now. But because I stopped resisting eventually and I said to myself, what if it works? Everybody's saying, what if it doesn't? Well, guess what? I'm betting on myself that it will work. And then you make it happen. So that's today's note. I look forward to tomorrow. Folks, tomorrow we are back with the ME Show at 7 p.m. Eastern Time. And it broadcasts everywhere. YouTube, Facebook Live, in the same page that you are in right now. Periscope, everywhere really we broadcast. And we even turn it into a podcast afterwards. But I look forward to an incredible topic that I have for you all tomorrow. And it's going to be how to monetize your brand. How to monetize your brand. That's something that all of you need to do immediately because you all have greatness, but you are just acting as a sales rep instead of a CEO of your own brand. And I don't mean that in a disrespectful way. I'm only saying what you need to hear as a reality check so I can spark change and eliminate resistance. And yet again, I'll have another note for you from The Secret. And we are, first of all, very grateful for all of you for giving us the opportunity over the last month of April. We had an incredible month. That being said, we focused on branding and becoming an attraction machine throughout the whole month. We've done 4 webinars that talk just about branding. They were complimentary webinars, although they're literally worth thousands. And for those of you who were in the webinars, you know what I'm talking about. This month is going to be all about prospecting mastery. So everything is about how to master prospecting in the month of May. And the very first webinar is going to be Thursday night at 8 p.m. Eastern Time. 100% all about prospecting mastery. So I'm excited about that. The link to register for it right now is workwithali.com/prospect. I think workwithali.com/prospect. I'm pretty sure that's the link for it. And you will be able to register right away. It is, again, 100% complimentary for you. I just want to try it here to make sure because we just got it from our web designer that just created the whole link for us. Again, that's workwithali.com/prospect. And yes, I was right. So go ahead and register right away because, again, it's going to be an hour and 15 minutes of incredible information, all of our scripts of how we've built and developed a network in 9 countries, how we can guarantee you a sit down and an exposure with the right prospects, how you eliminate wasting your time with the wrong prospects, with the negative prospects, and everything that you need to know about attracting clientele, about attracting representatives, about attracting the right network to you and the right customer base, because many of you are flying everywhere and telling everybody about how great your product is, but you do not understand that there is a specific language for your specific prospect kind. And if you don't identify that, you're probably going to be struggling. So workwithali.com/prospect. Looking forward for you all to register. And I will be talking to you at 7 p.m. Eastern time tonight on Periscope. And immediately after that, I am doing an 8 o'clock presentation, global presentation for our company. And then at 8:30 Eastern Standard Time, we are doing a major conference call for our lovely, amazing founders and partners all over the world, which I am super excited about. And we have a special guest, Mr. Kevin Marino, a 7-figure earner. I cannot wait for you all to hear everything that we have going on. So keep it in here with us. And also on the Insta stories and the Facebook stories where I keep you updated and probably entertained too. So love you all and I'll talk to you soon. Take care, everybody.